It will go gamma, as we say, we hope, at the next meeting. Okay, a bit of history. The problem is now that I cannot see my own screen. So
what you do?
I first ran into you into Lua when I was trying to extend the editor that I'm normally using, which is called Skite, and it has Lua scripting language built in. And it took me quite a while to cross the barrier to say, okay, let's look into it, because at that moment I was mostly using Ruby. But I liked it, and I think it was at probably at a Dante meeting that I talked with Hartmut. Hartmut is in the PDFTech team, one of those people who always tries to explore the boundaries and tries to do the things that are not so obvious. I said, well, how about a Lua command inside PDFTech? And he actually did it within a day, I think. And then I played a bit with it, and actually, I think at one of the tech meetings, did a presentation about it, about the potential. And then we had a meeting of the PDFTech team, where Hartmut Tark and I also discussed these matters. And actually, more or less automatically, we came to the conclusion that it would be a good idea to start thinking about the next generation of PDFTech as being a version that was enhanced by Lua. By some coincidence, at that time, Idris, who will also do a few talks today, got pretty frustrated by the everlasting bugs in Aleph, and he needed, for high quality error typesetting, a proper tech engine. And he was thinking about, well, we need to have a better tech to do that. And at that moment, the three of us, Ida is also on the contact list, so that's a bit the environment where this discussion takes place, said, well, how about a project where we can combine these objectives? Well, it took a while, but eventually, Ida managed to get funding from his university for co-development, which means that Taco could dedicate company time to writing the code. So how is it currently go? Taco does much of the coding. He knows tech, well, inside and outside, I would say. And I mostly deal with the Lua side. And together, we Skype up the specs. We are in sort of constant Skype sessions already for more than a year. It starts in the morning, and code flies in both directions. And this is the way the project goes. And so far, my colleague never wondered if it would make sense that I spend most of my company time on it. I think by now we are more or less convinced that this is the way to go. A few of the objectives. Taka will go into more detail about these things later, and I will also explain a few of the things. But this is just a rough summary. Internal quantities would have to become larger than they are now. UTF-8 would be the way to go. There are always these interfering and everlasting tech optimizations that get into the way. Open type, this was one of the reasons why it was discussed in the PDFTech team. Open type support, needed to be added to PDFTech. And since LuaTech is more or less the successor of PDFTech within the team, OpenType was a natural the demand of the system. Bidirectional typesetting should go in there. We would like to open all the internals of tech for as much as possible to the Lua scripting engine. And, well, especially Dark and I have a rather long list of things that we want tech to do, especially in certain areas. And I think the only way to get them done is to extend tech a little bit here and there. And, well, this is one of my personal favorites, yeah. Those who know context know that Metapos is pretty well integrated, but well, if you process documents where you have some 500 subruns of Metapos, it's not really fun. It's more natural to have it integrated. Well, how do we work? There is, although it may not like seem to be so, we do have a kind of planning. This is, well, more or less the result of the Oriental Tech project that is financing the thing. It meant that there had to be really a plan, underlying plan, stepwise implementation of things. Occasionally we peak really in the late in the evenings, in the weekends, when things are really becoming unstable and we want to get it stable again. In that respect, tech user meetings are really good points in the development line, because then something needs to be finished. And I can tell you, even to get, I think not this, but one of the later presentations running, Taco had to fix a couple of bugs. So what do we do? We talk about it, we explore ideas, start to implement something. I start writing Lua code. We use actually context for testing the stuff. We use real documents, and it also means that bugs and all kinds of other aspects quickly show up. And as the last remark, we really rewrite a lot of code. Sometimes we have two or three re-implementations of the same or slightly different ideas. We try to keep up with documentation. That's mostly what Taco is doing. I try to keep up with more or less stepwise description of what we run into and how we solve the problems. It's also aspects like benchmarking timings and whatever. And eventually we still have the idea that there should be a Lua dev book someday. Okay, so how does it fit into tech development? PDF tech version 1 will be frozen. There will be no new functionality added. There will of course be debugged. It will be adapted to changes in the PDF spec, but there will never be basically a version 2 of the current thing. Lua dev is thereby de facto PDF dev version 2. Internally, it already has PDF dev version 2. But we probably will keep the name. This has to do with the fact that there may be some compatibility issues that we have to deal with, and it's good to have the stable PDF dev down there and the new Lua dev there. It's also related to other projects, as a tech guide project. By now, if you are a reader of usable magazines, you should by now know that this project is there. It's funded by all the user groups. One of the reasons for triggering this project was that in order for PDF dev to go open type, we need fonts. So all the fonts that make sense in the current tech light distribution will be extended and moved to open type. They will all get full mark support, if possible, with the full Unicode coverage. This is, I think, one of the biggest cross-user group projects that currently runs and is substantially funded. Oops. And PLIP, this is another project that is funded by user groups, which is actually dealing with Metapos as a library. Maybe there will be a Lua post someday. context, which we use as a tech development platform for this, also moves on to the next generation. So the current context version is internally as version number 2, and the next one will have version number 4, also called Mark 4. Well, where does Lua show up? User can directly call it. I think we will see more examples of that later. There's an independent library, TechLua. This will have quite some impact on distribution, because we certainly have a scripting engine that ships with tech distributions. Maybe Carl can make some remarks about that later. Developers can extend or replace existing functionality. So then that's more for the developers, the Lua things. And this is an important thing. New functionality, we don't change the tech engine, new functionality will and has to be written in Lua. And maybe even existing functionality will be rewritten in Lua. And eventually, we may have something completely different than we have now. Helper code is written in C, so it currently have a mixture of the old stuff, Pascal, C code, and Lua. Well, we have the direct Lua command, we have cut code management. Just this is a short summary of things that we have done so far and we will more or less report on later today. We have possibilities to overload file I.O. This is more or less the order in which things went. We have TFM and OpenType font loaders. We have hooks into the tokenizer. We have node handler and node attributes. This is something that I will talk about later, especially the attributes is something new. And, well, there's some more to come. But, and this is a very important thing that you also need to keep in mind if you listen to the talks following that goes, is that we will not provide solutions. Okay, there will be lots of code, and I try to make a lot of generic code. But there's one lesson I've learned from all discussions about successors of tech the last couple of years, is that they were just discussions. There were never any solutions. There were never any real successors. And I think one of the reasons is that there are too many solutions for the same problem. So what we do is we open up the engine, we give you as developer whatever the means, and making the solutions up to you or us. But okay, how about the future? This is something we'll not discuss today, I think. We plan to open up the paragraph and page builders. There will be extensions to Maas. Error handling, very important aspect. There were several talks this conference about user-friendliness and embedding things. I could show example of a few of these things if people are really interested, but this is a major major thing. And in the process, existing code needs to be cleaned up. And on the long end, we may end up with a completely split up tech loop, more or less a bit the same thing as what you mentioned with what Adobe, I wasn't aware of that effort, is doing. But then I think we are talking, well, maybe 2 or 3 years along the road. Okay. So this is a short introduction. Some of these aspects will be discussed in more detail in later talks. Others may come up at successive tech meetings.